Assalamu alaykum, everybody. It's 12:47 p.m. Where's the vlog? Well, I'm not vlogging today. I did vlog yesterday, but I'm not releasing that until probably next week sometime. Because right now I'm doing something and I don't want it to interfere. I don't want my vlogs to, or what I said in my vlogs to interfere with what I'm doing. So you'll know when I release the vlog. It'll be for yesterday instead of, you know. So I thought what would be nice is that I do a tag. So a sister, I don't know her name, but her channel is Niqabi Focus. She sent me a tag. So I thought on my lunch break, and it's a nice, very long lunch break, I thought I'd answer these tag questions. So let's go ahead and get started. All right, so there are 8 questions. I reviewed those questions, and some I may be able to answer, some I may not be able to. So we'll just go along with it, inshallah. All right, so question number 1, how long have you been wearing hijab? Well, I've been wearing hijab since, I've been wearing hijab for years. Let's see, it was after, 2002, sometime after 2002, sometime after 9/11. I know, I've converted to Islam before 9/11, but I started wearing hijab a bit after 9/11, 2002, maybe about October, November-ish of 2002. I think it was like late 2002. And have I ever taken it off? No, I have not ever taken it off that I can recall. I mean, I take it off when I'm with my family, but that's usually if I'm in the home of my family. But outside of that, no, I have not ever taken it off since then. I was tempted to take it off when I had some hate speech slung at me when I was driving home with my son at the time. And again, this was like after 9/11 had occurred. That was the one time that I thought about taking it off. But then I stayed strong and kept my hijab on ever since then. So question number 2, have you ever been bullied or made fun of for wearing it? No. I have not been bullied or made fun of because I wore it. I know early last year, when I was in the store, some ignorant guy came up to me and said that I'm a disgrace to my country or whatever because of my niqab, because of what I'm wearing, you know, my abaya, my hijab, my niqab. And but I mean, I didn't really react to that. I was just like, you know, whatever. And then one lady, when I was on the way into the store, she said, go back to my country. And I told her that I am in my country. But that was pretty much it. But as far as like being bullied to take it off, no. Not that I felt. So, question number 3, what does hijab represent to me? Hijab to me represents my individuality. It represents my faith in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, my obedience to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That's what it represents to me, my freedom, my sense of individuality, my sense of security. So that's what it means to me. The next question is, did you decide on your own to wear it, or did you grow up wearing it? Well, I'm a revert to Islam, or convert to Islam, so I didn't grow up wearing it. So I decided to wear the hijab on my own, especially when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala had commanded us to wear it. So if it's Allah commanding me to wear it, it was my decision to wear it. Number five. What are some common misunderstandings? That I'm oppressed, which I'm not. My husband or my family made me wear it, which is not true. Those are the common misunderstandings. Those are the only things that I really come across, though. That's it, really. Number six. What are some funny stories that you have experienced? I don't think I've really experienced any funny stories. I mean, there's a couple of times being a niqabi that I just went out the house without even thinking that I forgot to put my niqab on. I've never gone out without my hijab. Never. That's my extension of my skin there. My hijab is always on me. But for my niqab, there's like a few times where I would leave the house and completely to raise my niqab up to my face and put, you know, have it on. So, I mean, those are like the funny times right there. I mean, that's pretty much it. Number seven, do you have any advice or tips for those struggling or seeking to wear it? Take your time. I mean, for me, I was still learning, but when I learned from the Quran that Allah had commanded me to wear it, I had given it thought. I thought about, okay, how would this affect me and the people around me and my job? Before I started wearing my hijab, I told my supervisor and the people that I work with that starting the next Monday, I would start wearing the hijab, and I told them why. I told them that I am a Muslim, and I told them that I'm going to be wearing hijab, and that was that. If you're going to be wearing hijab, you may, it may help you to just let people know, hey, by the way, I'm Muslim, I'm going to start wearing hijab. You're going to start seeing me with it, because it'll make them feel more comfortable. It'll make them know what to expect, and it'll make you feel more comfortable. Take your time. You may not be ready. I mean, you may have been, used to always, looking good with your hair down and all this stuff. And you're so used to styling your hair certain ways and things, but which is, where I was before. But you have to put all that aside and know that what you're doing is for the sake of Allah, is for the sake of pleasing Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And whatever you did before, that's gone now. And now you're tasked at trying to reach Jannah. So take your time, and when you get ready to wear it, just maybe let people who you're close to or you work with know what to expect, so that they're not shocked. I even did that with when I started wearing niqab. Even though I don't wear niqab at my job, on campus, I did let them know, hey, I'm going to be wearing niqab. So if you see me around and about off campus, don't forget to say hi. It's still me. I'm, I have not changed. I just raised my level of my worship to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So, yeah. And then the last question, how do you feel about niqab, and would you ever consider becoming a niqabi? Well, I'm already a niqabi. I've been a niqabi for almost 2 years, and I feel blessed. I feel like my niqab just further gives me more security. It humbles me tremendously. I mean, even when I'm in, even when I'm at work, I find sometimes that if there's a lot of men around me, I tend to bring my hijab up just a little bit to, you know, to obscure or hide my face a little bit, because I don't want any particular male kind of doning on me or anything. And I don't mix. I don't mix at all. I mean, the only time that I will mix is in the meeting, and that's for the purpose of work. But outside of that, you don't see me mixing at all. So, I love being a niqabi. I love it. I was terrified of it before because my thought was, oh, you have to wear black all the time. And I'm not the kind of person that wears black from head to toe. I'll wear black as long as there's some kind of contrasting something on me. But, and I'll wear other dark colors too, but that terrified me before. But when I saw a sister, mashallah, she's a niqabi from Tanzania, and she wore colors and she was beautiful, mashallah, beautiful. And that's what took me out of that fear, that yes, I can be a niqabi and I can wear colors. Allah provided those colors. I'm not the one kind of person to draw attention to myself, so I don't do bright colors anyway. But I don't want to feel like I'm a shadow in the night, where I blend into everything dark. I mean, yeah, I don't want to bring any attention to me, but I don't want to feel like I'm fading away into nothing. So when I saw her wearing those colors, mashallah, I was like, oh, you know what? I can be a niqabi. Let me try it out. And the more I tried it out, the more comfortable I felt. And it was a major transition for me from going to how I used to wear my clothes, how I used to wear my hijab. Then where I have sworn off abayas, I found beautiful abayas and started wearing those. And where I said I wasn't going to wear niqab because I didn't want to wear all black, I started wearing niqab. And I wear black, but I have to have something. I have to have something of color up there. But all down, no, no, unless there's designs. If there's like designs on my abaya, on my black abaya, I'm okay. But if it's all plain and I'm wearing a plain black hijab and niqab, I can't do it. I can't, I've tried it and I just can't do it. I can't do it. But anyways, everybody, inshallah, you have enjoyed this tag. If you did, give it a thumbs up, leave a comment below, let me know, have you struggled with any hijabs or niqab, and if so, what did you do, or are you still struggling with it, and why are you struggling with it? Inshallah, this tag will inspire you, or what's the word I'm looking for? Inshallah, it will, yeah, inspire you to, you know, to wear the hijab or niqab, you know, to follow Allah's commandment to cover yourself. So it's a struggle. Yes, even with wearing niqab, sometimes for me it's a struggle. But I mean, I pick where I wear my niqabs depending on, okay, what the situation is, security and everything. But other than that, I wear my niqab everywhere. So yeah, I hope you all enjoyed it. Niqabi Focus, since you gave me the questions, I'm tagging you to answer these same questions that you sent to me. And I tag any other niqabi sister as well. So definitely leave a link to your channel with you answering the questions, inshallah. Yeah, I'm so blessed, mashallah, to have so many sisters in my circle on YouTube. It's and I pray that it keeps growing and growing. The sisterhood just keeps growing and growing, inshallah, because you guys you interact with me, and it's blessed. It's so blessed, and I appreciate it. And I love you all very dearly for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And I will see you in the next video. What that video may be, I don't know yet, because I don't know how long I'm not vlogging for. So I'll see you in the next video, inshallah. Don't forget to subscribe, leave a comment, share with others in our ummah. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Bye.